Hi, this video is from interview.com. interview.com is a job portal. If you're looking for a job, you can log on to interview.com and you can post your resume with us. In this video, I'm going to talk about five basic Java integrations. Can you name few design patterns used for designing Java applications? There are a lot of design patterns, but few are very basic. Singleton pattern, factory design pattern, abstract factory design pattern, proxy pattern, command pattern, and builder pattern. Can a class extend an interface? A class can implement the interface, an interface can extend another interface. Okay, so a class can only implement the interface, it can never extend an interface. Which of the following is tightly bound? Inheritance or composition? Inheritance has more coupling, actually speaking. So the subclass knows more information about the base class, whereas in composition it will not have much information. It knows only the methods, but how they are implemented, the base class, the contained class will not know. Whereas in here, the subclass knows a lot of information about the base class. Give an example for generics in Java 5. Generics is used for whenever we create an collections. So the collection comes to know what type of object they are going to store. So that's where generic comes into picture. So during the creation itself, we will say this collection will have list of strings. If you don't keep this string, what will happen is it can accept any object, and there will be a class exception or it'll in future. So even before, while creating itself, you should be typed the type. You should know the type of the object that you are going to add it into the list. In the case of map, same thing. I'm going to have a string as key and string as value. How can we make sure that a code segment gets executed even in the case of uncatched exceptions? So you can put it in the finally block. So if there is any issue or exception happened, the finally block will always be executed. So you don't have to worry. You can place the code in the finally block. Finally block will always be executed only in case of system.exit. When this JVM crashes or shuts down, finally block will not be executed. In other cases, always finally block will be executed. Hope these questions are useful. Thank you and all the best.